Hi there, Steven Dowd from EnduRow Challenge. A little different this week on the performance psychology pro tips section. Up until now, what we've seen is Dr. August Leming give us some fantastic nuggets of advice for the preparation side of EnduRow Challenge, getting yourself in the right headspace. He's currently going through the section in the middle, during the row, the sort of thing that you will come across as you're rowing in EnduRow Challenge. And then towards the end, what we're going to see are some more reflective videos looking at what we've just done and the lessons learned that can be then applied in later life. So unfortunately, because of the way COVID is happening around the world at the moment, we're in lockdown again in the UK. I'm back to homeschooling. I'm having to flex my resilience muscles. You know, things are not going to plan. But wine helps, so that's a good thing. However, unfortunately, Dr. August Leming is also facing a similar challenge himself. So this week, I'm stepping into the seat, quite literally, after having done an erg workout myself. And as I was preparing for this video, I thought to myself, what nugget of information could I give across that I use in my life, both from what happened to me with paralysis and overcoming paralysis from the neck down just a few years ago, and translate that into the world of rowing and training for rowing. Now remember, I'm not a rower, so from my point of view, these are not hard and fast skills that I've had for years and years. These are things that I learned during the paralysis journey that I've been able to transfer across. And I'm hoping that this will be something that you can benefit from too. So really, it all revolves for me around goal setting. One of the most important things in terms of progress and moving forwards in a significant way is having the right direction and the right structure around the goals that you're about to achieve. So I break it down into two main camps. My first is the gold medal winning, high level goal, super bold, super ambitious. It's going to take a lot of time, it's going to take a lot of work, it's going to be very highly complex, but it will give you a direction and it will give you a reason, a purpose to be moving in that way. And then when you couple that really powerfully with small incremental goals, chop up that big goal into tiny little bits and just tackle each one of those little bits. That could be multiple goals in one day. That could even be multiple goals in one session. So as I say, I'm going to use a working example. I've just stepped off of my trusty erg, my water rower here, with a 2,000 metre piece in mind. I set off at zero and I have to get to 2,000 metres. For me, with the level of paralysis that I still carry, that's a really big ask for me. That's a long way. It's over 200 strokes, and each one of them is relatively complex. So what I have to do, in my mind, is not think about the 2,000 metre goal, not think about the end of the piece. What I need to think about is, what am I going to do in the next fraction of that? And I break it down into 10 pieces. So my 2,000 metre goal is actually a 200 metre goal times 10. And as I go through that 200 metre goal, which is about 20 strokes or so, I use some of the advice that we've already heard from with Dr. August Leming about watching and noticing where I am, smiling when I find it really difficult because that changes my physiology, being very noticeable on the individual technique and where I am in my stroke to make sure that I'm hitting the right thing at the right time. And then once I get to the end of that 200 metres, I can tick that button and I can move over to the next 200 metre block and I start again. So it's a short win, it's a short term goal, 20 odd strokes, I get there, I win, I immediately set a new goal and I move into that new phase. If I do that 10 times, I get to the end of my 2000 metres and I come out on top. So my advice to you is, be mindful about goal setting, have bold ambitious goals, break those down into manageable chunks, and just keep ploughing away. Until next time, everyone, everywhere, pulling together.